And the next sutta is 8.3.21. Once the Exalted One was dwelling in the gable hall in Mahavana near Vaisali. There the Exalted One addressed the monks, saying, "Monks." "Yes, Lord," they replied. And the Exalted One said, "Hold it true, monks, that Uga, the householder of Vaisali, is possessed of 8 wonderful and marvelous qualities." Thus spoke the Exalted One, and thereafter, rising from his seat, the wayfarer entered the dwelling. Now a certain monk, robing himself early in the morning, taking bowl and cloak, went to the house of Uga, the householder, and there sat down on a seat made ready for him. And Uga of Vaisali approached that monk, saluted him, and sat down at one side. Then said that monk to Uga, "It has been declared by the Exalted One that you, householder, are possessed of 8 marvelous and wonderful qualities. What are those 8 marvelous and wonderful qualities, householder, of which you are declared by the Exalted One to be possessed?" And Uga said, "No, Reverend Sir, I know not of what 8 marvelous and wonderful qualities I am declared by the Exalted One to be possessed. But as to the 8 marvelous and wonderful qualities found in me, listen, lend an ear, and I will tell you." "Very well, householder," replied the monk. And Uga said, "When I first saw the Exalted One, even a long way off, my heart, sir, at the mere sight of him became tranquil. This is the first marvelous and wonderful quality found in me. Then with tranquil heart, I drew near and reverenced the Exalted One. And to me he preached a graduated discourse, that is to say, on almsgiving, on virtue, on heaven. He set forth the peril, the folly, the depravity of lusts, and the advantages of renunciation. And when the Exalted One knew that my heart was clear, malleable, free from hindrance, uplifted, lucid, then he revealed to me that Dhamma teaching to which Buddhas alone have won, namely, dukkha, its arising, its ending, and the way to its ending. Just as a clean cloth, free of all stain, will take dye perfectly, even so, as I sat there arose within me the spotless, stainless Dhamma sight, that whatsoever is conditioned by coming to be, all subject to ending. I, sir, saw Dhamma, possessed Dhamma, found Dhamma, penetrated Dhamma, overcame doubt, surpassed uncertainty, possessed without another's aid, perfect confidence in the word of the teacher, and there and then took refuge in the Buddha, in Dhamma, and in the Sangha, and embraced the 5 rules of training in the holy life. This, sir, is the second quality. Now, sir, I had 4 wives, young girls, and I went and spoke to them thus, 'Sisters, I have embraced the 5 rules of training in the holy life. Who wishes may enjoy the wealth of this place. All may do deeds of merit. All may go to her own relations and family. Or is there some man you desire to whom I may give you?' And when I had stopped speaking, the eldest wife said to me, 'Sir, give me to such and such a man.' Then I had that man sent for, and taking my wife by the left hand and holding the water pot in my right, I cleansed that man by an act of dedication. Yet I was not a whit discomforted at parting with my wife. This, sir, is the 3rd quality. Moreover, sir, there is wealth in my family, but among the good and lovely in character, it is shared impartially. This, sir, is the 4th quality. And when I wait upon a monk, sir, I serve him respectfully and not without deference." That is, without respect. "This, sir, is the 5th quality. If, sir, the reverend monk preach Dhamma to me, I listen attentively and not listlessly. If he preach not Dhamma to me, I preach Dhamma to him. This, sir, is the 6th quality. Furthermore, sir, it is not uncommon for devas to come and declare to me, 'Perfectly, O householder, is Dhamma proclaimed by the Exalted One.' When they speak thus, I reply, "Ho, you Devas, whether you declare so or not, Dhamma is perfectly proclaimed by the Exalted One. Yet, sir, I feel no elation because of such thoughts as, it is to me these Devas come. I am the man who talks to Devas. This, sir, is the seventh quality. Of those five lower fetters, sir, declared by the Exalted One, I see no remnant whatsoever within me. This, sir, is the eighth marvelous and wonderful quality found in me. These, sir, are the eight marvelous and wonderful qualities found in me, but I do not know of what eight I am declared by the Exalted One to be possessed." Then that monk, after taking alms at Uga's house, rose from his seat and departed. And when he had eaten his meal, after his alms round, he went to the Exalted One, and saluting him, stood at one side. So standing, he told the Exalted One of all his conversation with Uga, the householder of Vesali. And the Exalted One said, well done, monk." As Uga, the householder of Vesali, in explaining the matter rightly, should explain, "Even so, monks, he is declared by me to be possessed of those eight marvelous and wonderful qualities. Moreover, monk, hold it true that Uga, the householder of Vesali, is so possessed." That's the end of the sutta. It's quite an interesting sutta. In the days of the Buddha, you had such good lay persons like Uga. Because of past life, the moment he saw the Buddha, his heart became tranquil. The last quality, the Uga says, is that those five lower fetters are no more in him. In other words, Uga was an anagami, a non-returner, third fruition person who has perfect sila and samadhi. And you notice, when the monk came to see Uga, it is stated here, and Uga of Vesali approached that monk, saluted him and sat down at one side. In other words, this lay person, even though he's a third fruition person, an anagamin, he pays respect to the monk. He does not think, "Oh, I am an Arya, I'm higher than the monk, I don't need to pay respect." Because during the Buddha's days, they took refuge with the Bhikkhu Sangha. And because the monk wears the robe, even though he is anagamin, he still pays respect. The word abhiva detava, saluted, that means paid homage to the monk. You notice that after he understood the Dhamma, he wanted to practice the spiritual path and keep the five precepts. He told his four young wives that he wanted to practice the holy life. And one of them wanted to marry another man, and he just gave away his wife. And then he says that he has wealth in his family, but those who are of good character, he shares with them just like his brother. He shares with them impartially. That means he gave wealth to whatever virtuous person needed it. And then when he serves a monk, he serves him respectfully. And then if the monk teaches Dhamma, he listens very attentively. If the monk comes to his house and does not preach Dhamma to him, then he preaches Dhamma to the monk. He's so capable. And Devas used to come and talk to him. So then, those are the wonderful qualities of the Uga. Yeah.